Welcome back to another Math in a Hoodie video. I've got on my favorite hoodie again, and I'm so excited to be here with you and break down another math concept. Okay, today we're going to talk about writing out a number. There's lots of ways that you can express or say a number, okay, and we're going to go over those different ways. And by practicing this, it helps you practice your numbers so that you can identify them quicker and so that you can help learn your numbers faster, which helps you become a better test taker, do your assignments better, and get more 100% and A pluses, right? And then you guys can become your strong math warriors. So practicing your numbers is really helpful and important, and I'm so excited to do it with you guys today. So let's get started. Okay guys, so I'm gonna tell us our first number and we're gonna write it out or express it in four different ways, okay? So the first number is 15, 1, 5, 15, okay? So the first way you can write out a number is just by the digits, and that means just the numbers. So we would just write out 1, 5, 15, okay? That's the first way. The second way is to write it out in a word or words, right? So let's write the number 15 in a word. Okay, so we write the word 15. Okay, that's the second way. So the first way is the number, the digits, and the second way is by the word. Okay, now the third way is place value. Do you remember place value? Place value, we take the number 15, and as we've learned in our place value video, each number, no matter what order it's in, each number has a place value. And it just tells us which order the numbers come in, okay? Now the last number is always the ones. And the next number is the tens. Okay, so if you know which place value goes where, it's really easy to look at a number and say, oh, the fives the ones and the ones the tens. And then you could put it 5 ones and 1 10. But let's say you forgot which order numbers come in and you don't know which number is in which place value. Well, we can write out the number in little dots, okay? So let's write out 15 dots. And when we do this for place value, we always write them in groups of 10, okay? So I'm gonna write 10 dots on the first line. Let's see how many I have. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, there's 10. Let me keep going now. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Okay, we have 15 dots and we put them in lines of 10 or groups of 10. Now, we only have 5 on the bottom, huh? We didn't have enough to make another group of 10. So let's count how many groups of 10s we have. Well, that's a group of 10, so 1. And then this one isn't. So we only have 1 group of 10. So we're gonna put 1 under the tens, okay? Now how many little ones were left over? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we have 5 ones. See how we did that? So if you don't have the place values memorized, you can always write out the number in groups or rows of 10 and you can still find your answer, okay? All right, so now let's go to number 4, which is to write it out in a math problem. So this first one is addition or plus, right? And we want an addition problem that equals 15, okay? The second one is a subtraction or takeaway problem, and we want that to equal 15 since our number is 15. Okay, let's start with the plus. So if you have to pick any number, let's start with an easy number, right? Let's just start with 1. We'll start with 1 for the plus, and 2 for the subtraction, okay? So what number plus 1 would equal 15? What number plus 1 would equal 15? What do you think, guys? Do you think it's 10? No. What plus 1 equals 15? It's 14. Good job. 14 plus 1 equals 15. Good. Let's move to our subtraction. What number minus 2 equals 15? So for this, we're going to go the other way. We're going to need a number bigger than 15 because we're going to take 2 away from it. So what number minus 2 equals 15? Okay, well, the answer is 17. Good job. 17 minus 2 equals 15. Good. So now we've covered all four ways of expressing or identifying the number 15. Good job, guys. This is great practice. Okay, let's try another number. Okay, guys, let's go ahead and practice with the number 30, okay? That is 30. So our first way of just writing it out in digits would be 30, okay? That's 30. Okay, let's move to number 2, the word 30. Can you write that? What does that start with? A T-H, 30. It's kind of like thirsty, but without the S, huh? 30. Okay, there's our word 30. Those are means the same thing. One's just in digits and the other's in a word form. Okay, let's do our place value for 30. Let's write it out. And we remember that the last number is the ones and the next number is the tens. So how many tens are in 30? 3, right? Let's put our 3 in the tens place. And how many ones do we have? Well, we have a big fat 0, don't we? And even though there's no value in 0, it means zilch or nada, that still is a place value. So we have to write 0 as the ones. There's no ones, x. So we just put 0, okay? Now, remember, if you forgot which number is in which place value, you could write out 30 little dots in the groups of 10, and then you could count how many groups of 10 you have. 1, 2, 3, so you'd put 3 tens, and then there's nothing left over, is there? And that would be the ones, would be the 0, okay? All right, our last way is with our math problem. Now our answer this time for each problem is going to be 30. We already used 1 and 2 last time. How about we add 3 and we put 4 in the subtraction problem, okay? All right, let's figure this out, guys. So a number plus 3 is going to equal 30. That's kind of a big number, isn't it? Something plus 3 is going to equal 30. For the subtraction one, we're going to have a number takeaway or minus 4 equals 30. That's going to be a big number too, isn't it? It's not quite like the 15 that we just did, huh? All right, so what plus 3 equals 30? In order to figure this one out, we got to count before 30, right? So let's count 3 numbers before 30. So we have 30, 29, 28, 27. Is that the right one? If we put 27 here, does this problem make sense? 27 plus 3 equals 30. Does that make sense, guys? Show me a thumbs up if you think that makes sense. It does. 27 plus 3 is 30. Good job. Okay, let's come over to this one now. And we need a number subtract 4 that equals 30. So we're going to go the other way this time. Okay, so when we added, we need a number below 30. To subtract, we need a number above 30, don't we? Okay, so something minus 4 equals 30. What do you think that could be? I have an idea. You guys tell me if I'm right or not. I think it's 34. What do you think? Give me a thumbs up. Do you think it's 34? It is. 34 minus 4 equals 30. We can also count to verify that that's correct. So let's take away 4 from 34, okay? 34, 33, 32, 31, 30. Is that 4? Sure is. And what did we end up at? 30. So 34 minus 4 equals 30, doesn't it? Okay, good job, guys. So we went ahead and did all 4 of our formulas or forms of expressing the number 30. Okay? All right, let's try one more number. Okay, guys, let's do one more number. You're doing such an awesome job. It's really fun to practice our numbers, isn't it? I think so. Okay, let's do our last number, and this time our number is going to be 22. 22, right? Okay, let's write that digit out. 22. There you go. That's the first form in showing number 22, is by using the numbers or the digits. Okay, let's do the word. Can you guys spell 22? When we do a number like 22 or 35 or 56, we always put a dash because it's 20 and then we put the second number, 22. Okay? So there's our word for that one, 22. All right, let's do place value. Again, if we look at the number, we can tell the last one is our 1. So what number are we going to put in the 1s box? 2, right? This is kind of easy because you can't get it wrong. Your only choice is 2. So you can put 2 in each and you'd be right. But not all of them look like this. So you got to know your place values. So the last one is the 1s. The next one is the 10s, isn't it? And if you didn't remember which was which, you could write out 22 little dots and you do it in rows of 10 and then you'd have 2 little ones left over and then you count how many groups of 10 you have. You have 1 group, 2 groups. So we put 2 in the 10s, we have 2 little ones left over and that would go in the 1 slot. Okay, good job. Our last one is our math problem. So our addition and our subtraction problem need to equal 22, okay? We already did 1, 2, 3, 4. How about we do 5 and 6? Ooh, it's getting tricky. All right, let's figure this one out, guys. What number plus 5 equals 22? So we need a smaller number. We're going to add 5 to it, and it's going to give us 22. Okay, let's think about that for a minute. I'm going to give you a second. Count backwards from 22 by 5, and that'll give you the answer, won't it? Okay, I'm going to put my suggestion up here. I think the answer is 17. Can you give me a thumbs up if you think I'm right, or a thumbs down if you think I'm wrong? Well, in this case, I'm actually right. Yay! 17 plus 5 is 22, right? Because if we check our answer, 17, we add 5 to it, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, then that would be correct. Okay, let's go over to our subtraction problem now. And we need a number, subtract 6 to equal 22. So in this case, we need a larger number than 22, right? Because we're going to take 6 away from it in order to get 22. So in this case, we're going to want to add 6 to 22, and that can tell us the number. So we're going to count upwards from 22 by 6. Okay, let's try that. 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28. Okay, we counted 6 numbers above, didn't we? And we got 28. Is that the right number? It is, huh? 28 take away 6 equals 22. So that's correct. Good job. Okay? See what you guys did? There's so many ways that we can express a number. And I'm so glad you guys practiced them with me today. So have a good day, and I will see you guys next time on Math in a Hoodie.